Want to get really motivated and have fun when you're learning English? Watch this video to find out how you can teach and learn English with games. Let's go! I'm Deirdre Nicholas from Palm Tree Teaching TV, your personal English language coach. I've created this second video about how to teach and learn games in English because so many of you enjoyed the last one that I did and asked for more. So here it is. Games and fun activities are a really important part of teaching and learning English. As a learner, you will be more motivated and excited to learn English if it's fun. And as a teacher, games will leave your students leaving your classroom wanting to come back for more. Do you want really engaged students? Then give them games as a way to learn. There are loads of reasons why games should be a part of your English, whether you're learning it or teaching it. They can help you to learn English faster, improve your English understanding, and help you to learn phrases and vocabulary much better, and often in context too. Now, in my first video, I talked about how games can improve your learning of English, so be sure to watch that video with this one. In the classroom, you can use games as a warmer, at the beginning of your lesson of course, during the lesson to change pace, or if the students are not as engaged as they should be, you make sure that they're more engaged that way, and also at the end of the lesson as a consolidation, like a plenary, of what you've just been teaching. And as a learner of course, it's a really fun way of learning English with friends or with family. So today, I'm going to get straight into more games, showing you how to use these to increase the fun in your English lessons and in your English learning. So, number one, chalkboard acronym. This is a great simple game for developing vocabulary mainly. Write a word vertically on the board and then have students come up one at a time to write a word starting with each letter of the vertical word. So for example, you could write a word like table, and then you would have words such as tall, apple, button, lake, elephant. You could make it harder by using a theme or a part of speech such as adjectives. It could look like this. The word could be huge, so you would get students to write up words such as helpful, ugly, gorgeous, elegant. Of course, as a learner, you can easily adapt to using this yourself, either on your own or with a friend, and using a sheet of paper. Number two, put yourself in someone's shoes. Now, on the idea of developing unusual adjectives, here's another game that is brilliant for that. It develops vocabulary, creative thinking, and it needs writing too. This game is for any level of English learner, from elementary through to pre-intermediate, even upper intermediate. It tests students' knowledge of adjectives concerning physical appearance, phrases to explain hobbies, and vocabulary for clothes too. Now, this game can also be differentiated for different levels. So for lower level classes, you could start with a review of the vocabulary that they're going to need to use for this activity, this game. For higher level, more advanced students, you could start off with like a debating question, such as, what does it mean to put yourself in someone else's shoes? So, divide the class into pairs. This works quite well for large classes, actually. So when they're in pairs, give each pair a picture of a pair of shoes. It could be red high heels or bright yellow sandals, something unusual. The students then have to imagine the person that owns that particular pair of shoes. So each pair must describe this person in detail. So what they're wearing, what they do in their free time, what their job is, using a range of verbs and vocabulary. Then get the students to write it all down, accurately of course. Of course, more advanced students can even create a story about the person that owns the shoes. There are loads of possibilities. The other great thing about this game is you can actually use it for really large classes, such as 40 or 50. You can divide the students into teams rather than pairs. It's also a game that you can do at home with a friend. You can have real fun with your imagination. Oh, before I share the next game, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you don't miss any of these videos and lessons. And also, if you'd like me to coach you on a one-to-one basis, either as a teacher or as a learner, just email me on deirdre@palmtreeteaching.com. You may even have an important interview coming up or an exam, and I'm here to help you with that. I can help you prepare for the interview and for the exam as well. So just contact me if you need me. So, game number three, taboo. Of course, this is an old favourite. It works really well with students to practice their descriptions and synonyms. So separate your class in half and have the two teams sitting opposite each other. Each of the teams chooses one person to sit in front of them in the hot seat. As the teacher, you stand behind the students and you hold up a piece of paper with a word on it, but make sure that the person in the hot seat does not see that word. So then you give your teams a time, like say 3 minutes, and they have to get the person in the hot seat to say the word. But here's the catch. Your teams can't actually say the word itself. They have to describe it and find ways of trying to get the word from the person in the hot seat. Game number four. Where shall I go? This is a really great game for testing prepositions of movement, and it can be used as a teacher, of course, it can be used after you've presented the vocabulary as a way of consolidating their understanding. It's great for speaking and listening. Also, as a learner, you can just do it in a pair. So if you're a teacher, before your students arrive, rearrange your classroom so that the chairs create lots of obstacles. Then, when the students arrive, you put them into pairs and you blindfold one of each pair. Now, the blindfolded student is led by their partner through the maze of chairs and given directions by the partner. These directions can be prepositions of movement, such as go under, go over, go to the right, go down, until the person reaches a particular place in the classroom. Of course, you can also do this outside in a park or a garden. That works really well, both as a teacher with a class and as a learner. And this could actually add extra vocabulary, such as walk 50 paces or something like that. And then, of course, you swap over the partners. So I've put a couple of links to how you can use games to learn English, both as a learner and also as a teacher in the classroom. And I put the links below this video for you. They're all free. So don't forget to like and subscribe to this amazing channel where you will build your English fluency and improve your English fast. So I hope you've really enjoyed this video. Enjoy learning your English and I'll see you in the next video really soon. Bye!